present an ensemble of English ladies and gentlemen in their elegant attire and gracious manner, yearning to please all of you present here with their formations and graceful moves. Children, it was a nice performance. Cheer them, children.
Of the state, our fathers, brothers, sisters, my dear staff, parents, well-wishers, and friends, and my dear students, I'm very much delighted to be witnessing this great event today, and I am very happy to celebrate with you this annual sports day. I know that this event is planned with a noble mission to provide a platform platform for all of you, my dear students, to display and exhibit your talents, your potentials, your skills of varied kinds. At the outset, I congratulate and I thank the management, staff and students for planning this meet and conducting it. I thank God for the gift of this institution, this school over here, and all the many blessings that all of you receive through this institution. Just a few points of reflection. True education has to touch all the domains of the child's personality with a very comprehensive curriculum in a very balanced manner, facilitating the development of intellectual, emotional, spiritual, social faculties of a child. And this, along with the academics, the sports and games, and all the display of talents or exhibition of these talents and potentials, must form an integral part of the education. We know the familiar saying, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. It's a very familiar saying, but it's always a truth. Now, having this opportunity to participate in the physical activities and in the aesthetic cultural activities, it helps you all to refresh your mind and body, to revive yourself and feel lot of good feeling within your hearts and minds, and it rejuvenates you in all levels. There's a misconception that competitions are bad, because some of us think that because of the competitions, some of the students' self-esteem is affected and they feel discouraged. But the truth is that to lose is not to be a loser. While you enjoy the winning thrill, you also need to experience the losing, so that when you experience this winning and losing in a good spirit, you are prepared, my dear students, for experiencing all the challenges or facing everything that may come in life. Competitions provide surely an opportunity to achieve with a strong motivation the goals that you set for life. It also helps you to demonstrate determination, triggers your creativity, and help you to accept the winning and the losing, and look for making your maximum effort and achieving your best. Competitions also gives you inspiration, if taken in the right sense, to develop your additional skills. But we also need to know, winning is not everything. All the same, we need to have a winning attitude. That is a positive attitude, a win-win attitude. I win and you win. And this sort of disposition will help you in life to face life's lessons. My dear students, while you learn all these values and the qualities in the sports arena, you also learn along with it the lessons of life. How you can take winning and losing in a balanced manner. All the values that you exhibit, the team spirit, the endurance capacity, the tolerance of one another, the rejoicing at the winning of the other, the good disposition to accept losing sometimes, help you in life. My dear students, one very important quality expected of you when you participate in different competitions and displays is the spirit of sportsmanship. The capacity to take all the experiences in a balanced way, with a pinch of maturity, team spirit, tolerance and goodwill. While you enjoy displaying your skills of many kinds as you display right now, and also participate in the competitions of athletics, games and other drills and such, you also exhibit lot of rejoicing, enjoy lot of fun and laughter, and I am sure this helps you for developing and fostering a good emotional bond among yourselves and develop more friendships. My dear students, I have to congratulate you for the display of varied games, varied drills, varied dances, all in multicolors and fashions and styles. I wish to congratulate the principal and also the staff, every one of you who have worked along with your students to have this spectacular show. I must say it is indeed a great show. And surely this type of shows, participations, mirrors the quality of the students, the teachers, the management and all concerned in this educational endeavor. While I wish and congratulate the management, the principal, the staff, the students and also the parents who have wholeheartedly cooperated with the school's programs, I also thank God for all of you and also wish you the very best in life. My dear students, take every opportunity to multiply your talents. Let it be in the sports, let it be in dances, let it be in music, let it be in acting, or in all spheres, in all domains of your personality. Seize all the opportunities available, offered to you, with a lot of planning from the management and the school. Take it well for your all-round development of your personality. The displays conveys certain values, certain themes, and it helped you to understand the utility and the benefit of taking part in physical activities, in movements, and the qualities involved, then the values involved in all the displays, the perfection, the team spirit, the friendship, the encouragement, the multiplication of your own talents. This was a beautiful occasion for you, my dear students, my dear parents. While you have given yourself to this performance today, be happy that your students are growing up, your children are growing up in a very good atmosphere, a very holistic atmosphere where they learn lessons of life. And all these such situations help you with the right motivation, because all the goals that you set in life, in the sports or in any aspect, help you to put out and trigger all your capacities and think and do hard work, coming out of your lethargy, your sluggishness, your comfort zones, and think positively, productively while you are a student. And I want to tell you and assure you, the qualities that you develop as this, multiplying your talents, giving your hard work, your incessant work on your talents will help you in the course of life. Once a champion of the World Cup football champion was questioned, "Sir, what is your secret of your success?" And he very promptly said, "It's very simple. When I play football, I play with all my strength, my spirit, my capacity and all my skills. When I do not play and when I am in conversation with someone, I continuously speak of football. All my love for this game will be expressed and I will try to motivate everyone around me. And when I sleep over the football." So, my dear young boys and girls, little children, this is a secret of developing not only the football game skill, but all the skills and values in life. So, my dear people, my dear parents, thank you for the cooperation that you continuously extend to the school management to do our best. I wish to congratulate once again the principal, all the sisters, the faculty members, staff, helpers, supporting staff, all people associated with this institution. Thank you for your contribution, and I wish that this contribution will be continued in the years ahead. And I assure you that you will experience lot of good feeling within. That may be the reward that you would be getting. God bless all your endeavors and all your families. Thank you.
Thank you, dear sister. This is the first call for the wheelbarrow race. Children in the wheelbarrow race, please go to the starting point. We now have the standard A program. Dance is a performing art form consisting of purposefully selected sequences of human movements. This movement has aesthetic arts by performers and observers within a particular culture. Other forms of human movement are sometimes said to have dance-like quality, including martial arts, gymnastics, cheerleading, etc. Here to display a few multi-talents.